Hi, my name is Katie Legan, and I'm a PM intern here at Microsoft. In this video, I will cover how to set up and use the Intelligent Recommendations Power BI reports. First, make sure that you have watched the Quick Start Guide video to create your Intelligent Recommendations and storage accounts. You will also need to make sure that you have installed the Power BI desktop app. Next, I will discuss how to set up the Signals dashboard and some of the data it provides, and then I will move on to discussing how to set up and use the IR dashboard. Navigate to the Intelligent Recommendations website and go to the Tools page. You will start by downloading the Signals dashboard. Once we click Download Signals Dashboard, the Power BI desktop app will open. There will be a pop-up, and you will need to enter the URL to where your model.json file is stored. To find this, you will open your Azure Storage portal and click on your storage account. Then navigate to your container, open it, and click Properties. Copy this URL. When you return to the dashboard, you will paste this URL and add IR root to the end of the URL. Click Load. The first time that you use this dashboard, you may be asked for your account key. To find this key, return to the Azure portal and open your storage account. Then click on Access Keys in the left menu. Click Show Keys on the top, and then you can copy key 1 to paste into the account key field in the dashboard. You will then click Connect on that pop-up window. Once the data loads, you will see the reports appear. In general, the Signals dashboard is most helpful before building your model. It will help you gain a better understanding of your data and whether it is sufficient enough to build a model. Throughout this report, the data is color-coded to help you understand how formative your signals are. Ideally, you want to see green values, as this means that your data is suitable for IR. Otherwise, orange means the data is borderline. If a data point is red, that means that there is not enough data, and that particular statistic might not have any meaning. For example, if all customers only buy one item, there is no way to understand the connection between multiple items in a basket, so we would be unable to provide recommendations for those. Therefore, if most of this dashboard is red, you might consider whether it is worth bringing your data to production, and if so, you might want to double check if your data is correct. However, even if there are some red and orange markers, that does not mean we can't model your data. Now I will walk through the tabs within this report. On the overview page, you can see general information about your storage account's data, such as the number of users, items, baskets, and rows in the data. On the collaborative analysis tab, you will see data based on items grouped by basket volume or grouped by users. For items grouped by basket, also referred to as the shopper's current cart, you can see the total number of baskets and compare that to the number of baskets that are actually useful for modeling. You can also see information about the items in the basket. The report shows the average number of items per basket, which represents the shopper's cart size. You can also see the total number of items, how many items are informative, and the average number of baskets per item. For items grouped by users, you will see the total number of users, how informative the users are, and how many items a user has. On the Users tab, you will see the number of users and the number of new and returning users over time. Additionally, the report will show the average number of baskets and items per user. In the Baskets tab, there is information on the number of active baskets, how the number of baskets has changed over time, and the number of items per basket. On the Items tab, the report shows information about all the items in the catalog. You can see the number of items over time. You can also look at information related to users per item, which demonstrates how many users interacted with a certain item. On the Popular Items tab, you will learn about which items were interacted with the most. You can also see the number of baskets over time. In all the previous tabs, you were able to see aggregated data about your signals. In the final tab, the Direct Associations Analysis allows you to see data based on a chosen seed item to give you a better sense of what items are most associated together. This information is particularly helpful for evaluating next best action models. To see data, you will first select a seed item, which would be an item that a user might click on. Then, the data will populate with products related to the seed item, and you can see the number of times that the recommended item was purchased, the number of times that the recommended item was bought with the seed item, and the probabilities that the items were purchased, given that either the recommended item or the seed item was already purchased. Now that we have reviewed the signals dashboard, we will set up the IR dashboard. So now we're back on the Intelligent Recommendations website, and we will start by downloading the IR dashboard. Once the Power BI dashboard opens, you will input your storage account name, your container name, your reports directory name, which is the logs folder, and your modeling component name. Then click Load. You can see the Intelligent Recommendations dashboard only after the first time your data is finished cooking. This dashboard will provide statistics about the performance of your models. Once the data loads, in the Interactions Dataset Summary tab, you can learn more about the dataset in general. The report tells you how many users, items, and rows are in both the full and sampled data. In the PAL Coverage tab, you can see how much of your data is suitable for the People Also Like model. The graph shows the percentage of interaction signals that the model can provide a recommendation for. So a higher percentage means that more of your data can be used. In this example, 100% of your interactions can be used in recommendation. The PIC Statistics tab is used to evaluate the performance of the PICs for You model. This report can help you understand whether relevant recommendations are appearing towards the top of the list. You can see metrics such as picks recall at top K items, which will show you the fraction of relevant items that were recommended in the top K items. You can also see mean reciprocal rank, which will take the reciprocal of the rank of the relevant item. A higher reciprocal rank shows that the relevant items are closer to the top of the list. Finally, you can see the proportion of relevant items that are in the top 1,000 of the list. On the PAL Statistics tab, you are able to see all of the same metrics as the PIC Statistics tab. Here you can instead evaluate the People Also Like model to determine whether relevant items appear towards the top of the People Also Like list. Thank you for watching, and be sure to check out the other videos in the series linked below. For more help and information, be sure to check out our Dynamics 365 community at community.dynamics.com. Thanks for watching.